Hello, good evening everyone. Welcome back to my channel, most especially to my students from Moraya College and of course to from Trinidad Municipal College. We are now on the Anti-Hijacking Law or Republic Act 6235. I include this topic because it is part on a crime against national security and law of the nation. Now, on the Anti-Hijacking Law, I will discuss only on those act prohibiting or which are acts that is inimical to civil aviation. And now, when we talk of anti-hijacking or hijacking law, there are two crimes of or there are two acts nating considered: hijacking on Philippine aircraft and hijacking on foreign aircraft. So I want to emphasize on this topic because it is very important to differentiate between hijacking on Philippine aircraft and hijacking on foreign aircraft. Now, under Republic Act 6235, there are four prohibited acts. First, by compelling the pilot of an aircraft of Philippine registry to change its course or destination or by seizing or usurping control thereof while it is in flight. And second, by compelling an aircraft of foreign registry to land in Philippine territory or by seizing or usurping control thereof while the same is in the Philippine territory. But before that, ato sang kuhaon, ug unsa ang pasabot sa the word hijacking. Of course, hijacking is committed by a person who compel the course or destination of the aircraft of the Philippine registry or aircraft of the Philippine registry. So, iyahanggi, say for example, iyahanggi pa ko sa mga destination. Say for example, miingon si perpetrator nga, ang iyahang flight ha, ang iyahang flight, sa gitawag na itong Philippine aircraft, is going to Japan. Ginan siya sa perpetrator nga, o Mr. Pilot, gusto na ko nga ang imuhang destination, instead of Japan, gusto na ko mo kag Davao. Ha? Mo iyahanggi ingon, or else patyon di ka. When we talk of hijacking, makonsider na to siya as coercion. Ha? There is a coercion, matawag na ito nga na coercion. Nga naman, gikompel man nimo ang usa ka tao to exercise those acts na dili niya ginabuhat. Based on na sa akong facts na gihatag niya na ko nga, ang iyahang point of destination is going to Japan but gikompel siya ni perpetrator or ni accused or ni culprit nga ang destination is Osbon. Ha? To change its destination. Mayingon ha? To change its course or destination or by seizing or usurping control thereof while it is in flight. Klaro ta ha? While it is in flight. Ha? Mao na siya ang definition sa hijacking. And of course, mao na siya ang i-apply nato on Philippine aircraft. Ha, Philippine aircraft, gitawag yan, nagibuta nga, while it is in flight. Klaro ta ha, basta mayroon kita og Philippine aircraft, naana ang word nga while it is in flight. Now, ang atong pangutana, sir, kanusta mo ingon nga, ang usak ka aircraft is naana sa gitawag nato nga while it is in flight. Kinahanglan ba sir nga maglupad na ang aircraft para mayroon ta while it is in flight? The answer is no. Mayroon itag while it is in flight, matawag na siya nato nga flight from the moment, ha, from the moment nga na-close na ang iyahang doors and windows for embarkation and following the opening of the doors and windows for it disembarkation. Once ma-close na ang tanan ng mga doors and windows sa aircraft, dahil ni-commit si perpetrator nga i-compel niya, i-change niya ang destination or else patyo niya ang pilot, that time, muingon na ta nga there was hijacking nga nahitabo. Provided ha, nga ato ang gigamit is Philippine aircraft. Ha, Philippine, I mean, ang ato ang aircraft ana sa pag-commit ni perpetrator is Philippine aircraft. Ha, I hope you understand ha, basta Philippine aircraft, timan na to nga, while it is in flight. Timan niya, while it is in flight. Now, on the second paragraph, by compelling an aircraft of foreign registry to land in Philippine territory, or by seizing or usurping control thereof while the same is in Philippine territory. Wala niya gi-require on the second paragraph nga niingon siya nga while it is in flight. Ha? Wala niingon nga while it is in flight. Paliko na to, foreign aircraft wala nag-require nga while it is in flight. Ang iyahang giingon is na ay foreign aircraft gi-compel or gi-seize ang control, for example, ni Mr. Pilot nga giingnan siya ni perpetrator o ang imong biyahe asa ang destination. For example, ang destination is sa Macau, niingon nga dili ayo pagadto adto tag China. So that is an example. That is an example of hijacking on foreign aircraft. Pangutana, sir, pwede ba ni makomit ang foreign hijacking on foreign aircraft ngadto sa Macau? The answer is no. Nga naman, it is territorial in nature. Klaro kayo, while the same is in Philippine territory, kinahanglan nga Philippine territory na commit ang hijacking on foreign aircraft. Ha, klaro ta ha. Nga wala sa taniingon nga while it is in flight, bisan pa og wala pa na totally closed ang ihang doors and windows, but there is an act of compelling to change its destination, ha, or seize or usurping the control thereof, mo-constitute na ang crime of hijacking. Klaro ta ha, balik ko na ko, Philippine aircraft, kinahanglan siya nga while it is in flight. Pwede na to i-apply ani ang gitawag na to nga extraterritorial application. Ha? While mingon ta sa paragraph 2, kinahanglan siya nga territorial application. Within the Philippine territory, gi-commit ang pag-hijack ni perpetrator sa foreign aircraft. Dili necessary nga it is in flight. While on Philippine aircraft, it is a condition sine qua non that the so-called Philippine aircraft must be in flight. Okay, now let us proceed on the third paragraph. By carrying or loading on board a passenger aircraft operating as public utility in the Philippines, materials or substance which are explosive, flammable, corrosive, or poisonous. So, mukonstitute gihapon siya as a hijacking. Nga naman, tanaw na to, passenger aircraft, pero passenger lagi, pero nagdala ka diha o mga flammable or explosive substance. Dili na siya pwede. Nga naman, klaro man kayo, passenger aircraft. So, ato sa na siyang i-determine. Otherwise, kung passenger aircraft na explosive diha or flammable substance nga nagsakay, ang katong nagpasakay, of course, ma-held liable for hijacking. On the fourth paragraph, by shipping, carrying, or loading on board a cargo aircraft operating as public utility in the Philippines, materials or substance which are explosive, flammable, or poisonous in a manner not in accordance with the rules and regulations of the Air Transportation Office. Kini, na siya qualifier. Kung maingon ta nga ang kanasiya nga substance, explosive, or flammable is in accordance, ha? In accordance sa kuhaon na to ang not, in accordance with the rules and regulations, since it is a cargo aircraft, pwede na siya. Nga naman, in accordance man siya sa Air Transportation Office, ang kana siya nga explosive or flammable. Therefore, dili ka ma-held liable for hijacking. Why? Because ang imuhang gisakyan is cargo aircraft, and in fact, naakay, si for example, in accordance ang imuhang pagpasakay sa flammable or explosive substance sa rules and regulations of the Air Transportation Office, basta cargo aircraft. But, kung ingon sa cargo aircraft pero not in accordance, ang imuhang pagpasakay ana, still mahil liable ka. But, on passenger aircraft, whether, say for example, ingon ta, in accordance with the ATO, dili gyapon siya ma, pwede nga ma, exempt ka or dili ka mahil liable for hijacking. Why? Because it is very clear na sad, on passenger aircraft, wala siya nagbutang o qualifier whether it is in accordance or not in accordance with the rules and regulation of ATO. Sa cargo aircraft lang siya, pwede na ito i-apply nga ka na si explosive, ka na si flammable, nga nahimu siya in accordance para pwede na ito siyang mapasakay na dili ka ma-held liable for hijacking. So I hope you understand on the discussion about the anti-hijacking law. Kung sa inyong timanan diha is kinigitawag na ito nga hijacking on foreign aircraft and hijacking on Philippine aircraft. Kaya mao na siya ay pinaka-importante o kanos ang maingunta nga there is in flight or wala siyang in flight or kanos ang necessary nga kinahanglan or kinahanglan nga in flight ang usa ka aircraft. O kanos ang ma-apply na ito ang extraterritorial application o territorial application on the Philippine aircraft and on the foreign aircraft. So, I hope you understand with this very short and brief discussion on the Anti-Hijacking Law or Republic Act 6235. So thank you and God bless us all.